In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of greater occipital nerve. Greater occipital nerve, which is this nerve. It looks very thin nerve. However, in reality, it is a little thicker, okay? A little bit thicker than it looks. This nerve is very, very important for headache. Okay, let's look at its orientation. Greater occipital nerve is from level of C2, cervical spine 2. Then it goes up along C1, along occiput. And actually it goes all the way up to parietal bone. So, greater occipital nerve takes skin sensation around this area. With that said, if greater occipital nerve is aggravated, you might feel headache. This area, this is very, very common. Let's say you have migraine, okay? Then if your migraine starts from backside of head and spreads to parietal bone, maybe your greater occipital nerve is irritated. You know, headache is very, very complicated symptom, but greater occipital nerve often involved in headache. This is profile view. Greater occipital nerve from C2 runs along C1 occiput, and actually it goes all the way up to parietal bone. It's like this. I would like to add one more nerve. There is another nerve which runs along cranial bone, okay? This nerve is from trigeminal nerve, and this branch is from ophthalmic nerve. Ophthalmic nerve. Part of ophthalmic nerve runs this way. Then there is connection around this area. So if greater occipital nerve is irritated, let's say it's irritated here, now that can create pain around here, then it can bring pain to this area. Why? Because these two nerves kind of connect together. So no wonder there's connection all the way up to frontal bone. This greater occipital nerve and ophthalmic nerve connection is very, very important. This is greater occipital nerve with muscle. So, this is trapezius. This is sternocleid mastoid. Let's say SCM, sternocleid mastoid. Trapezius. Greater occipital nerve kind of runs in between trapezius and sternocleid mastoid. What if sternocleid mastoid and trapezius get tight? That can create impingement here. Do you remember what happens if greater occipital nerve is irritated? That can create pain around here. So, greater occipital nerve and tension of neck muscles are strongly related. Then I would like to add one more thing. Again, this is greater occipital nerve. It goes along head. Interestingly, fiber from greater occipital nerve goes inside of cranium. Imagine like this. This is imaginary line. Then this nerve innervates dura mater. Dura mater, which is inside of cranium. This is membrane inside of cranium. Greater occipital nerve innervates dura mater. This is freaking important. So, if greater occipital nerve is irritated, that can create headache from outside. And also, that can create headache from inside, because this branch goes inside of cranium. This is freaking important nerve for headache. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of greater occipital nerve. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button. comment, and subscribe. See you next video.